here, you lose track of time. Hours melt into days. Days turn into years. 30 years in my case. After so much time in solitary, I should have been getting better. But in my heart, I always knew there was no cure for what happened to me. But I kept on hoping. I knew if I waited long enough, I'd get revenge against the man who destroyed my mind. But I could only wait so long. Every day, the visions got worse. Soon I wouldn't be able to tell reality from my nightmares. But then, my life changed. He called himself Calypso. He said he ran a contest. Winner take all. In my case, first prize meant getting even with the man who stole my sanity. How could I refuse? I agreed to play.
Thank you.
hadn't thought about the war in years. All the drugs and therapy in the world could never get me to talk about what I went through. But when I passed out, I couldn't escape it. The past came rushing back. It was 1971 again. And I was back in Nam. Ben had gone down. It was just me, all alone, trying to revive him. I was shouting to Benny, trying to see if he was okay. But before I knew it, the enemy was on me. They put us into some stinking hole, 25 feet below the ground. Benny was in bad shape. I didn't know how long he was gonna hold out. Seems like forever I was screaming for someone to come and help him. Then one day, we had a visitor. The guy was an advisor to the Vietnamese. And he had his own unique idea of torture. Starvation. Benny was on his last legs, and I wasn't far behind. 5 days without any food will bring any man to the edge. And the advisor said the only way I was going to survive was to eat. He gave me a knife and started laughing. He said if I wanted food, I'd have to make do with whatever I could find in the hole. I tried to block out what was happening. I knew what he wanted me to do, but there was no way I was going to give him the satisfaction. Benny died 2 days later. I couldn't look at him. I didn't even want to think about it. It's amazing the things you'll do to survive. I think Benny would have understood. They say the mind bends and twists in order to deal with the horrors of life. I think my mind bent so much it snapped in two. When a platoon of GIs freed me 2 weeks later, they tried to take the helmet off. I killed 4 of them before they took me down. After that, they shipped me back to the States and put me in the asylum. But now I have a chance to get even with the man who pushed me over the edge and made Benny die.
You Thank you.